Welcome back to Let's Play The Outer Worlds Murder on Eridanos Blind. We're going to talk to him at the beginning of last episode, and so we wandered around down there where all the employee quarters are, I'm guessing, and the bellhop's hanging out down there eating, and a lot of small, tiny little rooms. These poor people. Oh, I can take these. For whatever reason, I'm allowed to. Oh, this is back out to the murder scene. Fish stitch. Well, I'll just grab all this stuff. Down in the employee stuff, it's all, almost all stealing.
Discrepancy detected nearby.
Oh, bunch of nanners. Now before we talk to the chef, let's just see what this is, because I tend to forget.
Analysis of this stovetop reveals an alarming degree of grease buildup.
Oh no.
Approximating proximity to volatile gases and chemicals. Chances of an explosive combustion upon next use currently at 92.9%.
I wish I could save. Can I save in the middle of this? No. Alright. Otherwise I'd turn the stove on and see how it explodes. This seems like a workplace hazard. How hasn't SLUG caught this?
Searching SLUG work logs. No work log found. Creating conjecture.
Conjecture?
SLUG has likely not fixed this issue due to a lack of responsibility on the part of their employees.
Is this normal, though?
Most corporations have regular cleaning procedures to prevent damage to company property. SLUG, already unlike most corporations in a variety of ways, does not. That or the employees tasked with inspecting are shirking their duties. For shame.
For shame. Alright. Can we turn it on now? No, we can't look at it again. Okay. We have to behave like a normal person and not want to kill ourselves. Hello, Chef Anwar.
Yes? Are you here for the double rack of smoked sprat?
No.
Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, but you'll have to wait.
I thought it was a female chef.
Oh, don't give me that look. Let me see if I can pencil you in for later. Actually, what am I saying? I can't do that. I'm booked for the next month. You'll have to make a reservation.
Nah, no smoked sprat? What about purple berry glazed canid flank steaks?
Weren't you listening? We're reserved solid for the next month. I'm sorry, but you'll really need to order in advance.
I understand. Just get me some woolly cheese curds with fried nanners and I'll stop asking.
Is this some kind of a joke? We're not able to take on new orders at this time. I told you.
Really? Not even braised sisti ribs on a bed of mock apple leaves?
No, we don't. Why are you doing this? Please stop.
Got any ketchup?
Here! Just take it! Just take it and don't ask me for anything ever again!
Why are you talking about food anyway? Don't you care about the crime that just occurred?
Crime or no crime, I must keep my head on my work. One does not simply become the head chef in all of Eridanos by fretting over irrelevant happenings.
Since when is a murder irrelevant? It happened 15 feet away from your kitchen.
Well, it didn't happen in my kitchen. Who exactly are you, anyhow? What is it you want?
I'm here to investigate Halcyon Helen's murder. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
You're the inspector? Here? Why?
What else would I be?
You may ask me whatever you want. I have nothing to hide.
You said you were the hotel chef. What's that like?
I prep dishes day in and day out for guests, and while I doubt their palates are refined enough for my flavors, the work is rewarding.
Hmm.
After all, I can take pride knowing that I simply am the best cook this side of Halcyon. No one else can even hope to compare.
Right. Did you prepare all of Helen's meals?
Of course I did. I would never allow anyone else to touch the meals of so important a guest.
I'm surprised you would admit to that so openly.
Admit? What are you talking about?
If Helen was poisoned and no one else touched her meal, you poisoned her, right?
Oh. Oh my law, this is the end, isn't it? My mother always warned me that the culinary world was too dangerous.
She did?
But I didn't heed her warnings. Spencer Woolrich and Bellhop Owens were underfoot in the kitchen as I was preparing Helen's meal. Either one of them could have tampered with the food when I was fetching ingredients.
Hmm. Why are you being so evasive about leaving Helen's food unattended?
Well, it's a breach of professionalism, of course. Why else would I worry about it?
Because some Halcyon food combinations turn to acid when unsupervised?
What? Truly? That's an alarming business oversight. Instead of volatile chemicals, the corporations should put barbiturates in everything.
What?
Everyone likes barbiturates. But I don't believe that was a risk with Helen's meal. I was, up to something else.
Yeah?
I may have taken some time to engage in a teensy bit of recreational drinking, and consequently, I may have been somewhat less than coherent after preparing Helen's meal.
Hmm. So your alibi is a little thin here. Why should I believe anything that you're saying?
I understand your reluctance, but... Oh, I just remembered. The kitchen security camera. It'll prove I'm telling the truth about everything. Constable Keene has access to the security footage in her office at the spaceport. If you visit her, you can figure out what truly happened with Helen's meal.
Okay. What was Spencer Woolrich doing around in the kitchen?
Mr. Woolrich often finds the hotel's meals wanting. He seems to enjoy complaining in person.
That must be wonderful.
While I could appreciate someone with a discerning palate for once, I believe that Mr. Woolrich simply enjoys the attention he gets from us. Though don't tell him I said as much.
Yeah.
If you wish to speak with him, Mr. Woolrich can most likely be found in his suite on the VIP guest floor.
Yes.
He's usually there if he's not poking around here.
Yeah, you don't want to encourage him. Any idea why I might be able to find Bellhop Owens?
Yes, but not specifically. Owens often procures exotic ingredients from the creatures at the Wilderness Exploitation Reserve.
Ah.
Our guests can be rather... particular.
Sure.
Let's not talk about the incident with the Raptodon pheromone glands. It's always hard to say when Owens might be back. If I were you, I'd make a trek to the reserve myself. Otherwise, who knows how long you'll have to wait.
Right. Alright, that's all I want to ask about. I guess we'll see if you're telling the truth.
Thank you for your understanding, Inspector. I'm sure you'll find the true culprit before long.
Hmm.
Hello again. No new reservations have opened up, unfortunately, so I can't make anything for you right now. You have a look that screams, I have something to ask you about. Well, please, ask away. I have no problem with questions. Why would I?
That was a question. You seem pretty wed to your craft. Were you in the kitchen at the time of the murder?
No. As it so happens, I was down in the employee break room. I wasn't taking an unsanctioned break, of course. I was merely fetching ingredients.
Hmm. Dubious. I need a key card for that room downstairs. A ghostly voice came from it. Alright. Alright, so retrieve the kitchen security footage. Security footage of the kitchen would verify that Anwar wasn't the only one handling food in the kitchen. Even if the footage doesn't exonerate him, it at least casts some doubt that he was the poisoner. The footage can be retrieved from the constable's office at the docks. Speak with bellhop Owens. Owens was responsible for taking meals up to the VIP guest, suggesting that Owens may have had something to do with the poisonings. The bellhop was last seen heading to the Wilderness Exploitation Reserve. This is both elsewhere. All right. All right. The meeting spot. Where's the profitability? Somewhere out there. All right, let's get out and see where all this stuff is. She's over here. Constabulary. Bellhop Owens. This person looks like they're on a little area on this bridge. Maybe I'll do that. Where's the meeting spot? All the way over here. Where's botanical operations? Right nearby. Alright. Yeah, let's go find this, watchman. A SLUG agent recently went missing from duty given the circumstances. It's a matter worth investigating. The missing SLUG agent, Evan O'Connell, was stationed at the Wilderness Checkpoint building. That's the first place to look for clues. Evan was invited to an after-hours game of cards at the Botanical Operations building. Which is... surprisingly nearby. It's like surrounded by this hedge. Yeah, I don't think we've been in here. Let's look around the outside. No, nothing. All right.
They'll never see us.
All You're already in there? How are you already in there? Alright, close the door. I don't want the gardener to see. There's a slug bruiser. You're a friendly slug bruiser? Okay, good.
Why'd Helen have to go and die in our hotel? We don't need that kind of notoriety.
The Dissident Queen, Chapter 3. Halcyon Helen commits regicide. Some hours had passed since Helen's entry into the dissident hideout. She had fought no small number of slug men, destroying the abominations in singular fashion, and had met several employees from many corporations, each forcibly taken by the dissidents for use as test subjects. One such freed captive, who had called himself Hephaestus Harry, had accompanied her as she descended into the lair of the Dissident Queen. Helen had exchanged only a few words with him, and now would be able to exchange no others, as the man now lay in a bloody heap at the foot of the Dissident Queen, who, Helen now saw, was not a person, but a tremendous mutant slug. We got fiction imitating reality here. The dissidents, who had apparently been guarding her, were themselves quite dead and lay in various stages of mastication throughout the room. Well, that means they chewed on him. The queen feasted on Harry's remains, but as Helen stepped forward, the monster wriggled around to face her. "A true queen for a gang of parasites!" Helen shouted. The dissident queen reared back, opening its mandibles wide, and gave an inhuman shriek that shook the very foundations of the base. Heavy stuff.
Hey, you. Oh. What do you think you're doing?
Damn. I was just leaving.
Yeah. All right. I guess you're on the level.
Walking that way, though. I'm on the level, baby.
Beep, beep, beep. Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
And workbench. Work assignment list. A slug employee schedule. Under Crew C, Purpleberry Orchards and Connector Complex, someone has scratched out a name and replaced it with Evan O'Connell's. She walks back over there. We can take that stuff. Alright, let's examine.
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
The game.
Analysis concludes. The losing player used an overly cautious strategy that led to an insurmountable deficit in points.
Didn't Vargas describe Evan as overly cautious? I guess it showed in his play.
SLUG discipline records show a half dozen reports of illegal gambling and games of chance on company property. Perhaps there's evidence of an ante for this game?
Maybe he had a gambling debt someone cashed in on? Ah, you're over there now. Oops. I took it all. Require a SLUG storeroom key to unlock. Find a storeroom key in here somewhere? This goes back to the Grand Colonial. Where does this go in the hotel? Back here with the employees. Okay. Right. He's the one who said he was trapped in somewhere. We need
timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
We need that card. We need a SLUG card and we need an A2 card.
No, I'm sorry. We don't serve any drinks with those tiny umbrellas.
I do not want your umbrella drinks. We need to get in these rooms. How do we get in them?
Hello again. No new... You have a look that screams, I have something...
Yeah. Well, I never... Can we... Wait a second. Amelia Stillwell escorted Evan to room A2 in the lower level of the Grand Colonial to sleep off whatever was affecting him. Amelia Stillwell. Evan was invited to an after-hours game of cards at the Botanical Operations Building. Is this Stillwell over here? No, that's Halston.
The Grand Colonial Front Desk warmly welcomes you, and how may I be of assistance to you, Inspector?
wish.
The brochure never mentioned anything about mosquito attacks.
Finally checked in, I see. I hope you're fond of the penthouse. It's pretty much the best seat in the whole hotel. You shouldn't want for any amenity you might find elsewhere. Yeah. Should act as a better headquarters for the investigation than any space dust covered ship. That and you ain't got room service on a ship. You ever need anything, come find me. Even if you don't, you can still swing by. I'm always happy to chat.
Huh. Well, 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 if it ain't Lord Bellhop Alan Norville himself.
What? Oh, Laws, you didn't find my story, did you?
I did.
Sakes alive, that's embarrassing as all hell. I guess I should have hit it better. Well, since there's no way to put the leather boa back in the skinning machine, I might as well ask. What did you think?
Can't put the leather boa back in the skin. That's one hell of a turn of phrase right there. It was readable.
Well, it's only a second draft. I obviously wouldn't submit it to be turned into a serial until at least draft 4. I mean, I wouldn't submit it to be serialized at all.
No idea.
Now, what can I lend a hand with?
Did you know the victim?
Oh, of course. That is, maybe not on a personal level, but I'm one of her biggest fans. Even started an association of like-minded individuals.
Oh?
I'd lament not having anything to meet about anymore, but the newer tribe just ain't done it for us. Still, there goes my hopes of a Terran Monarch reunion episode.
So the funny thing is, we did talk to him before, but, I guess now that we read his serial, we have a lot more things to ask? Were the newer serial episodes that bad?
Of course! Budgets went up, but the writing quality chewed straight through the floorboards and free fell into Halcyon's son.
Huh.
I'm supposed to believe Helen would let the chief of the savages go free? Just since he was revealed to be her half-cousin? He's a dissident! You kill him! Hmm. I, like most fans, reckon this series should go back to its roots. Another 200 episodes of the Origins plotline is what we really want.
200 episodes.
Oh, of course. I'd lament not having anything to meet about anymore, but the newer tribe just ain't done it for us.
There are other celebrities,
still,
right?
They're... Sorry, friend, but I guess you don't get it. Helen was special, had a certain quality about her, like she would really go out and fight injustice. You look at Woolrich, and no disrespect to the man, but you just don't get the same feeling. He reminds me more of a vacuum suit without nobody in it.
Same.
Don't tell him I said that.
I agree.
Oh, of course. I'd lament not having anything to meet about anymore, but
I'm not gonna say that. Curious about you. How'd you get to be a bellhop?
Notice my battle-hardened physique, have you?
Yeah.
Used to be in a mighty mean line of work. Been shot at 35 times. That is, I've been near people who were shot at 35 times.
That's not the same.
But to be honest, I never really enjoyed it, you know? It's one thing to tightrope walk between life and death every day, but for just a handful of bits? Nah. When this position came up, I jumped on it and made a lateral move from sublight to slug. I ain't ever looked back.
How different is working with slug from working within sublight?
Well, slug is more trustworthy for one thing, where sublight is all about back alleys and backstabbing. Slug can be trusted not to salvage your ship when you turn your head.
I thought slug and sublight didn't engage much. How'd you move from one to the other?
Well, slug is something like an offshoot of sublight. It ain't too difficult to pivot from one part of the same company to another. Disconnects or no. That said, my departure may have been somewhat hasty.
Did something bad and had to make tracks, huh? I know the feeling.
I mean, yes, but I still earned sublight a hell of a lot of bits. Basically, I singled out a ship to salvage that I thought had been out for use for years. As it turns out, it belonged to a wealthy Byzantine who used it only to vacation. As it so happened, I still don't think she tried to use it, too satisfied with the luxuries of Byzantium. Still, I figured it was a good time to turn tail. in case that ever changed.
So you got any good stories? Sure you've seen a lot of people coming and going.
Stories? Huh. Actually, I think I got a couple now that you mention it.
Oh, goody.
Had a basket case visit from Fallbrook once. Almost took a swing at me when I tried to take his bag. Turned out to be full of live sprats. We charged him extra.
Okay. That's not that great of a story. Back to my other questions. You're supposed to say, now what can I lend a hand with? Mind if I ask you a few questions about the crime scene?
Please do.
I already asked all those. Okay. Bye. I think we're done in the hotel for now. How do I get... Oh, who was supposed to meet on the balcony?
Inspector.
Nope. So the balcony. This balcony, okay. Is this a different area? I don't even know if we can get up here. I thought they meant the balcony inside.
I can't believe Helen's gone. We're never gonna get a sequel to Terror on Monarch.
Oh, boo hoo. What's going on?
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby. Sampling of the bar card reveals it is host not only to alcohol, but a variety of other substances as well. Among the selection are Adrenatime, Pep Pills, Dervish Mist, and many other narcotics with unrecognized chemical signatures.
Taking any two of these at once could shut down most of a person's organs.
Chemical analysis confirms user comment. This news is unlikely to factor into the murder, however, due to frequency of Byzantine narcotic misuse.
I guess rich folk know how to party.
System error. By know how to party, did you mean die?
I don't know. Something tells me that won't miss a few extra bottles here and there.
Moralizing. It's not theft. It's object repositioning.
Oh. Someone was freaking out over here.
Thank the law. Dissidents don't belong in Byzantium.
Who? Who said that? Someone up there?
You know, I never imagined Spencer Woolrich would out...
I can't believe Helen's gone. We're never going to get a sequel to Terror on Monarch.
Ah, this the one? Donovan Mathis?
I won't tell.
Nothing in it. Just to store our goods, I guess. And I think I've been over here. Yeah, okay. Well, we'll talk to Donovan Mathis next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.